The billionaire financier and left-wing philanthropist George Soros has long raised the ire of Americans who believe that he's funding dangerous causes. Are they right? Or is Soros just a boogeyman for conservatives? It's worth taking a look at what Soros has actually spent his money on in recent years, much of which might be hitting your local communities. Since 2015, Soros has spent more than $17 million funding candidates for district attorney and other local races, apparently in the hopes of changing law enforcement systems at the local level. These races often feature candidates with little to no campaign funds, meaning that a single large dollar donation to one candidate could decisively shift the election in their favor. For example, in 2016, Soros dropped a whopping $2 million into a single sheriff race in Maricopa County, Arizona, helping left-wing challenger Paul Penzone win the election with ease. What effect have Soros' winning candidates had? In Philadelphia, the conservative candidate for district attorney, Beth Grossman, lost after Soros gave $1.45 million to help fund Larry Krasner, a former defense attorney who had never worked as a prosecutor. Under his watch, homicides jumped 40% between 2019 and 2020. Grossman later observed, "The role of the DA's office is not to conduct a grand social experiment. It is to enforce the laws of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania justly and fairly, and to protect the constitutional rights of everybody." Or look to Dallas County, Texas. Soros-backed district attorney candidate John Crusoe, who won, then announced he would no longer prosecute theft of personal items under $750. Violent crime then spiked 15%, and homicide 27.5%, leading the governor to send in state troopers. Or look to Cook County, Illinois' Kimberly Fox. Soros gave $400,000 to a super PAC that supported Fox, who gained national fame for dropping the charges against the hate crime hoaxer Jussie Smollett. But that's the least of what she's done. Fox decided to effectively decriminalize shoplifting. She decided not to charge shoplifters with felonies unless they stole over $1,000 in value or already had more than 10 previous felony convictions. Store owners blamed Fox for a string of thefts. Critics of Soros' efforts have raised the concern that funding of such left-wing candidates can weaken the vetting process for the candidate's character. It clearly has. Robert Schuller Smith, a district attorney for Hinds County, Mississippi, whom Soros backed, was tried in criminal court for two counts of suspected conspiracy to hinder prosecution and one count of suspected robbery, among other charges. But what's worse, the candidates Soros failed to vet or those who followed his agenda? I'm Chris O'Neill. If you liked this video, read the full article on our website, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.